हेलो एवरीवन। तो फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट विद एलईडी ब्लिंकिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट। ओके, एंड फॉर दैट वी विल यूज दिस सॉफ्टवेयर कॉल्ड STM32CubeMX एंड K version 5। ओके, सो बोथ सॉफ्टवेयर आर इंस्टॉल्ड इन माय पीसी। तो इनिशियली आई विल स्टार्ट विद STM CubeMX, राइट? And first of all, you have to click on new project, okay? Because we are building new project. And you have to select your target, okay? Either it could be MCU or it could be board. And since in image you can see we have Nucleo 144 board, so you have to click on board selector. You have to select part number. Here this STM Nucleo 144 type. Okay, and here you can see you have few suggestions, and our board is having this part number. Here you can see it's a 767ZI. Okay, so here you have to select the same part number, and then you have to click on start project. Okay, so initially it will ask this message: initialize all peripheral with their default mode. So you have to click on yes. Okay, so now next it will open this our selected part number, right? STM32F767ZIT, and this IC is having LQFP package, right? And here you can see some pins are pre-configured. Okay, for example, this is for this oscillator. This is user, but I think button is there, right? Then USB. Okay, then some of the pins are for different function like MDIO clock, reference clock. So before starting this configuration part, we will clear all these pin, right? And for the same, you have to use this option pin out, clear pin out, and click on yes. So now you can see all the pins are clear. Okay, now we know that we have two we will blink LED, right? So for the same, we will use two different pins and set them as a GPIO. Okay, you know in LED blinking you have to first set this particular pin with GPIO. Okay, set its direction as an output, and then you can write something. So if LED is there on that particular pin, so it will be turn on. Okay, and when you will write low, then LED will turn on. Okay, so for that we will select pin related to LED. But before that, first step is you have to collect crystal oscillator. You have to give some frequency, right? And for the same, you can see here different pins are there. Okay, you can select particular pin, and here you can see the changes, okay, as per your configuration. So to give the clock, we will use this RCC, and in RCC you have to set this crystal, okay, as a high speed clock. Okay, and here you can see after this configuration, we have this oscillator in and oscillator out, right, between these two pin. So now clock is there. Now next is you have to set, you have to give the pin, GPIO pin. Okay, so in this board we have onboard LED connected with this PB7. Okay, and so we will use this pin. Now when you will click on this pin, you have these options. Okay, so all the pins are having multiplexed functionality. So one pin can be used as I2C, as a timer, as a UART, right? So we will use as a GPIO, and its direction as an output, right? So GPIO output. So select this. So now you can see now this pin will work as a GPIO output. Okay, and on this board one LED is there. So we will use this pin, right? And we will write something on this pin, and you can observe that LED will turn on, right? And if you will write zero, then it will off. Okay. Now this is what the configuration part, right? So in this pin out, you have to set this type of functionality. Then next option is clock configuration in this software only, right? So here you can see clock configuration. So here, you know, number of clocks are there, right? This is the 96 megahertz clock is there. Okay, you can change this, the system clock, but we will not do anything with this. Okay, but if you want different clock on UART, then you can change these frequencies. Okay, some, you know, multipliers, dividers, and all these type of logics are there, and it provides clock on different peripherals, right? Here you can see, but in this experiment we will not change anything. Now next is configuration. In configuration, you know, we are using GPIO, so you have to click on this GPIO. Okay, and here you can see our pin PB7 is there, right? And here you can see user label is there, so you can give your label. Let us give label outset, right? Now you can apply these changes. Okay, click on OK. So now your defined pin is having this label charset, right? Then in this NVIC, it's called nested vectored interrupt controller, you have to select this option RCC global interrupt. Okay, this is related to that master frequency, right? Clock frequency. So this interrupt should be enabled, right? Then click on apply and OK. So now this configuration part is finished, and this is related to power consumption calculator, so we will not do anything with this. And now after this, you have to click on this project and you have to select this option generate code. Okay, so when you will click on this, so it will ask following thing. First is project name, so give project name LED test 1. Okay, in tool chain you have to select MDK ARM version 5 because we are using this. Okay, and then you have to click on OK. So it will generate now code for all this. Okay, so instead of creating new project, writing your application, okay, adding that application in your current project, this software will generate this code, okay, with all required library files. Okay, so as an end product, we have a ready-made project created based on our configuration. Now it will ask following option, open folder or open project. So we will simply open project. So by default, it will take this software Kale. Okay, Kale is already installed, so it will use this to open this created project. Okay, now you can see we have this project, and here you can see different folders, and in application user, your C file will be there, or your main file will be there, right? So based on a configuration, you can see various functions like HAL init, then system clock config and GPIO init. Now here you have to write user code. Here you can see user code begin and end, user code begin and end. So if you want to write a particular function and which should be executed continuously, then you can write in this while one loop. And if you want to execute function only one time, then you can write outside of this while one loop, right? It is up to you. And in this same application, at the bottom you can see our defined pin, okay, which is charuset GPIO port and charuset pin. So using this function, we will simply copy this function and we will paste in while one. So now this function will simply write one particular pin. And port and pin we have already selected, right? Port is B and pin is 7. because inbuilt LED is there on this board, right? And here you can write value. So one means it will write 3.3 volt on that particular pin. Zero means it will write 0 volt. So instead of this, we will write simple, you know, as an integer, we will pass this value. So let us create one integer. And we are giving value 0, then here we will simply invert this value continuously. At test is equal to not test. So first it will be 0. So after executing this, it will become 1, then again 0 and 1. Because of this while one loop, it will continuously keep changing. Right? And test is equal to not test. We are passing this. Now to observe this difference, means after high it will become low, we have to add some delay. So for that we are using this function HAL delay. In bracket you have to pass this argument in millisecond, right? So 1000 millisecond will be the delay. Okay, and this is what our code is, and now you can simply build this project. Okay, so when you will click on this build, so it will build your project, and it will take some time because here you can see in this driver you have all these files, right? So it will, in compiling part, it will consider all these files, it will compile all these files, right? DMA, Flash, RCC, R2C, I2C, all. And that's why it will take some time, right? And here in the image you can see we have this board connected with the PC, okay, using USB cable. Okay, now here you can see code is compiled successfully. We have zero error. So now we can load this binary file, because this code will simply compile your code. It will check any, whether any error is there in your code or not, and then it will simply create binary file, okay, for your project. So now we can load this binary file directly on the board, and since you know we have a onboard programmer, right? So we can directly use this scale to load our program. So you can check whether your board is connected with your PC or not using this scale software only. And for that, you have to select this option for target. Okay, and in this option for target, you can open this option debug. And in debug, you can see ST-Link debugger is there. And in setting, you can check. Using this ST-Link version 2.1, we have this device, okay, serial device. This is the serial number. So we have this device connected with our PC. And in flash download, you can select this option, reset and run simply, and then click on OK. Again, click on OK. And now directly you can load your code from this scale using this option. You can see. This download button directly download binary file into the flash memory of this board. Okay, so here in this image, you can, in this video, you can see a board is connected. Now when I will click on this load button, so you can see this LED indicate that program is currently loading. Okay, again you can see, right? And now you can see program is there in flash memory. And now I will reset this button, this board, using this button, right? And you can see our inbuilt LED is blinking, right? With this much interval. Okay, So this is using simple write pin function, right? Now we have this driver, so we can open this GPIO. In this GPIO, again, we have different functions, right? So let us use another function called toggle pin. So this is the function toggle pin, okay, and using this function also you can toggle this pin. So instead of writing high and low, simply passing this port number and pin number, you can toggle this pin, okay. So we will see this same experiment in next video. Okay, thank you.